Hi, welcome to my channel. Let's spread a spreadsheet. So in this episode we are going to see waterfall model chart, how to create a waterfall model chart in Excel. Now if you want to know about what is this waterfall model chart, so a cumulative effect, if you want to show something cumulative, okay, so that addition one by one, step by step. So for that purpose we are using this waterfall model chart. Here we are going to see some of the examples and let us see how to create a waterfall model chart. Now the first example here is our cost sheet. If you know costing, you will be very much familiar with this cost sheet. Even otherwise it is very simple to understand. So how this cost of a material has been arrived at, or selling price is arrived at. So material cost, labor cost and direct expenses for that material becomes the prime cost. And then if you add factory overheads, you get the work cost. Then adding admin overheads will give you cost of production, and selling overheads, if you add that, then you get the cost of sales. And if you add profit, you get the selling price. So here you can see the cumulative effect of the cost. Okay. So a better representation of this in a chart will be using waterfall model chart. So that's what we are going to create. So first of all, select the data, then click insert, then let us go to the recommended charts, and Excel gives you some of the recommended charts. So here I am going to here we can see the Pareto chart also, that let us see in another episode. So now we are going to this all charts, and let us select this waterfall model chart, which is a recent versions of Excel is having. So I'm having Excel 2016 and it's having waterfall model chart. So let us click this OK. Now it's creating a chart. Now there's a small problem in this chart. Even though you can see something step by step, it's going upwards, but when you are seeing 50,000 here, that is the sales. But here why we see this 2 lakhs, 2,50,000 and up, all these figures. So there's a small problem here that we have to explain. See, for example, the basic principle of this waterfall model chart is like this. We are having material cost, which is 10,000, and over and above this 10,000, we have this 15,000. So if you are drawing a column chart, it will be starting from zero. The labor cost will be starting from zero, but it's not the case in waterfall model chart. In this case, we are the cost is being added up and a cumulative effect is being created. So that is the importance, speciality of this kind of charts. So here the problem is, this 29,000 is not an expenditure by itself, it's a total. 10,000, 15,000 and 4,000 put together, it becomes a total. And then these two put together, it becomes 33,000. Excel as such, it takes this 29,000 also as an expenditure and makes as a cumulative effect. So to remove this, what we have to do is, we have to say this is as total. How to declare to Excel this is total, okay? So that's what we are going to see. Click it here and again click it here so that I can select only that part, and then right click it, select set as total. Now in this way we are saying that, okay, this amount is 10,000 plus 15,000 plus 4,000, which is 29,000. Then this is also a total. So let us select that and select a set as total. Then this also, same way this one also. Now our waterfall model chart is somewhat complete. That is, all these costs put together, factory cost, and these two costs put together, it becomes work cost. Like that it goes up to profit, and then how your selling price is arrived at. So it is like a waterfall, right? So wonderful chart. So very easy to represent some cumulative effect. Okay. Let us go for another example. Let us take this profit and loss account, which says how to arrive at this net profit. For example, sales minus cost of goods sold gives you gross profit, and all other expenses and then miscellaneous income added, you get the net profit. Okay. So here I have entered the negative numbers. Okay, -60,000, -2,500, wherever the amount is to be reduced. Here I am using minus quotes. So let us select the data again. Okay, once again, go to insert, and then recommended charts. I think so. Waterfall model chart will be a recommended chart here. So I'm selecting this and press OK. Now, as usual, I have to declare which are all the totals. Okay. In this case, this 40,000 is a total. Okay. We can see it here. This is a sum of this sales plus cost of goods sold, which is a negative number, and then make it a set as total. And this also is a total of this. Okay. So now you can see that sales, you can see the difference. Okay. Increase minus decrease is the next effect. So sales minus cost of goods sold is equal to gross profit, and then all these expenses, negative cost has been added, and then miscellaneous income is added, and then everything added together, you get the net profit. Okay. Another kind of example to use the waterfall model chart. Here we have another example, which is a stock price. So in a share market or whatever it is. So here I am selecting all the prices. The initial price 1990, we have 40 rupees, and cumulative effect, it has been added, decreased, or slashed, price getting slashed. Now at the end of the period, this is a sum. Okay, here you can see the total. So this is the total of cumulative effects, and now the price is 119. If you want to represent this as in a chart, you can use a waterfall model chart. Okay. So here is what I am going to select the data and go to insert, go to recommended charts, and go to all charts and waterfall model chart. So now it says 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. I want to format this data. Okay. So select this data, and in the horizontal axis or x axis, we select the years. Right. So now you get the period. So we get the period here. So in 1990 it is 40 rupees, and now it is 119. So let us select this as set as total. By this way, we can see the total ups and downs of the prices in the periods. Okay. So in a timeline, how a particular price gets changed. For example, let us take a small account here, having opening credit and then closing credit, and having various transactions in various in a particular year. So here I am selecting the transactions, and let us insert a waterfall model chart. So here I am selecting this. Now let us declare this as the total, so that will be the that will start from zero. And we can represent this as also the total. Okay. So opening and closing figures are given in as totals, and all increase and decrease, debits and credits, are in different colors. So how an account is getting increased or decreased, or what is the position now? Even this can be used for a stock position in a timeline. If you want to see a trend line, there we are using the line chart. But here I want to know the difference. I want to know the increase or decrease, how much it is. So if you want to concentrate on that increase or decrease, focus on this increase or decrease, then we are using the waterfall model chart, a wonderful chart representation of cumulative effect of anything. So friends, we have seen waterfall model chart and how to represent data in waterfall model chart in Excel. So let us spread a spreadsheet again. Okay. Thank you, friends.